On 13 October 2022, a tweet from the Government of India via Twitter handle named Spokesperson Ministry of Home Affairs, in which he told how thousands of people are falling prey to online job frauds. And some indicators have also been given through this Twitter handle, with the help of which you yourself can easily spot fake online job offers. Along with this, they have also released a website where you can register your complaint against any kind of cyber crime. So let us see what are those indicators with the help of which we can also spot online job frauds. First guideline. If you get appointment letter too quickly after the initial chatting, it may be something wrong, because for genuine company and its jobs, many things have to check and verify, and it takes time, so be aware about this type of situation. Second indicator, suppose you have received the appointment letter but job description is not clear. It is intentionally kept vague, and what will be your role in the company is not clear. Then this is the biggest and easiest way to differentiate any real and fake job. So my friend, you make sure that the job description and requirement of the role must be crystal clear. The next guideline, usually any email related to hiring is written very professionally. But if you feel that there are too many unnecessary things written in the email, there is a simple grammatical mistake, spelling mistake, or else if in the email the tone which is very unprofessional, it simply means that it is a possible job scam. Another guideline, if you have started working in a company and after that you are asked for necessary document and information, then it is okay to give it. But at the time of appointment letter, if they are asking for your necessary documents or information on email or mobile call, then it should never be given, no matter who it is. In such a case, you just politely refuse that, "Sir, if necessary, I will submit after joining, but forgive me for now." You should always remember that your necessary document and confidential information should not be given to everyone. Last but not the least, about the money. Because such deeds are intended to rob your money or some monetary gain. If during the hiring process an attempt is made to take money from you by any means, whether it is registration fees, entry fees, or any other means, there is almost 100% a job scam. In this case, you don't need to entertain them and refuse that you cannot give money in any way. Look, today is the age of technology. You or anyone cannot know in any way who is behind the screen. So whenever you deal in such a situation, make sure that you get offline once, and if you can't, then definitely do a video call to ensure originality. Now, if this type of any scam related to this has ever happened with you, if you are a victim of cybercrime, please register your complaint at www.cybercrime.gov.in. It is the website issued by the Government of India. Friends, as the internet grows, more such problems will arise. So we should know that how we have to behave on the internet and internet connected platforms, how to deal with its possible danger, and how we can make our presence on the internet safe and secure. For this, I have made a complete video on this topic. If you like, then I encourage you to watch it. With this, I end my talk. Thank you very much for giving me your valuable time.